to the season finale of the Data Game. I'm your host, Chuck Borg. At the end of the night, it will finally be narrowed down to one. Our final roast ceremony will determine who has captured our contestant's heart. Bachelorette, how are you feeling?
I'm happy as a daisy to be here. I am hoping to be able to find someone who can show me who the true king of their heart is.
Great, let's introduce our contestants. Contestant number one is a personal trainer from New York City. Contestant number one, care to introduce yourself?
That's right. If you're looking for a guy that'll make you do the whole thing, then look no further. I spend most of my days checking the mirror to make sure my tribes are looking defined. Well, when I'm not eating my lift at the gym, I'm downing roughly 12 protein shakes.
You drink 12 protein shakes a day?
No. 12 at a time. If you ever need a spotter, I got your back. I think you and I would make a great team. Once you see these guys, I'm sure you'll be your body.
I'm sorry, contestant number one. I am looking for someone who can look past the surface and does not dwell on the physical appearance of others. I cannot give you this rose. You are not the king of my heart.
Sorry, big guy. Looks like contestant number one needed to work a little less on arms and back and a little bit more on humbleness and humility. Contestant number two is a businessman. Contestant number two, care to share your thoughts? Contestant number two, you're fired. Contestant number three, would you like to introduce yourself? Contestant number three?
Sorry, I was answering a text.
Contestant number three, if we were to spend more time together, what would we do?
Have you seen this panda chewing boba gum? It's hilarious.
I don't guess I have seen that. Let me ask you a question.
Sure, what's up?
During our date, you seemed a little preoccupied. It didn't seem like you were fully engaged in the conversation.
Yeah.
I could probably say anything right now, and you wouldn't even have a clue.
Sure.
The room is on fire.
Okay. Oh, God, take this.
I'm not sure we've ever had somebody voluntarily leave before, but the show must go on. Let's introduce our next contestant. Contestant number four has become an internet sensation by online food blogging. Contestant number four, would you like to share with us your experience at The Bachelorette?
How should I put this? Ignore the slow service and the bland food, and the fact that they keep the lights in the restaurant so bright it'll fry your eyeballs. I would say it went pretty well. Hopefully my taste buds and pupils will recover one day so I can learn to enjoy food again.
And what about...
I'm just getting started. How long do you think it should take a valet to get your keys? We waited 12 minutes. They said they lost our keys. How do you lose keys? You put them in a box, and they sit there. It's ridiculous. You have one job. Now you make me and my date wait in awkward silence for 12 minutes. I can't hold a conversation for 12 minutes.
That's right. How do you feel?
I actually didn't mind waiting. The food was really good. I just wish we would have had time to spend more conversation between us rather than focusing on everything that went wrong. I do not see you being able to enjoy the things in life that are there to be enjoyed. You are not the king of my heart.
This means goodbye for contestant number four.
Great. Kick off the guy just as everything out of his control goes wrong.
Contestant number five. Contestant number five is known to like the finer things in life. His fanciness has stuck out. So what makes you think you are a potential suitor?
Well, that's right. Just like the rest of the contestants, we weren't able to have a date night and talk over dinner. But unlike the rest, I spare no expense. I pay for a reserve table with our own personal chef, and the place for $200 a pop. I think the chef more than the rest of these guys paid for all their dates combined.
That might be because the chef pays for the dates.
Do you think I can actually enjoy myself on a budget you guys give us? You can't impress anyone dressed like these guys. You know how much I paid for this suit? You don't want to ask.
How much was it?
It was $5,000.
Great. That's what I had to use.
The thing that stood out to me most was his smile.
Aww.
Well, yeah, that's because I spent $10,000 on these pearly whites.
I am looking for simple gestures of kindness rather than a extravagant living. You are not to change my heart.
Thank you.
I missed you so much. I'm sorry I ever left you.
I'm
sorry, are we in the middle of something?
No, let's just get out of here. Too bad our contestants were too busy looking in the wrong places. Thank you all for watching, and good night.